This conference will now be recorded.
चतुर्मुखसमारम्भं वाग्भटाचार्यमध्यमं अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तं वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। रागादिरोगान् सततानुषक्तानशेषकायप्रसृतानशेषान् औत्सुक्यमोहारदिदाञ्जघान यो पूर्ववैद्याय नमोस्तु तस्मै। सो नमस्ते टू वन एंड ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वी विल बी गोइंग स्ट्रेट टू द रिमेनिंग पोर्शंस ऑफ द्विविधोपक्रमणीयम अष्टांग हृदय एंड द रिलेटेड पोर्शंस फ्रॉम अष्टांग संग्रहम एज वेल। इफ आई एम राइट वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट ए फ्यू टॉपिक्स इन अष्टांग संग्रहम दैट why the sveda bhurita is there in sthula sveda vahi siramu siramula bhavadu visyandanadapi medasa shleshma yogacha bhavadi sveda bhurita, that is what we were discussing. Now I think before continuing with ashtanga hrudayam, there are some more interesting areas in ashtanga sangraha. These points I am discussing here because in our daily clinical practice, all these points can be used as leads which will guide us to come to a very precise or perfect explanation of many clinical conditions, especially in many sandarpanottha vyadhis. We are especially, as I discussed the other day, we the suicidalists especially are living among a huge list of sandarpanottha vyadhis. So the next line is something about what is going on in a sthula. Tulyebi vayuvadichaye prachidam चीयते तरम मेद तेन असमत्वेन धादूनं विदधादि तद् श्वासादीन अजिराच्चान्यान् ज्वरोदरभगंधरन् मेहोरुस्तंभ पिडगाविद्रधि प्रभृदीन् गदन् तुल्येऽपि वायुवादिचये प्राक्षिदं चीयते तरम मेद तेन असमत्वेन धादूनां विदधादि तत् श्वासादीन अचिराच्च अन्यान् ज्वरोदरभगन्धरान् मेहोरुस्तंभ पिडगाविद्रधि प्रभृदीन् गदान्। सो ही इज एक्सप्लेनिंग ए सिचुएशन प्रिवेलिंग विदिन द बॉडी ऑफ ए स्थूल। एक्चुअली इन स्थूल all doshas are in a vikrita avastha, all doshas are in vikrita avastha, so there is increase of all vayu pitta and kapha, and meantime as far as the dushya is concerned, medas is the most vulnerable element in a sthula. Meda, that is the most vulnerable element, and this medas has created such a situation wherein it is in perfect match with the shithila rasa dhadu what is getting formed. We have seen what is going on in the koshta, what is happening with the agni, all these things. So he is giving some further emphasis on the situation. The rasa dhadu is shlatha, shleshma yukta, madhura rasa pradhana, all these points we have seen. So this is in perfect match with the medo dhadu. So some sort of a samanya samanata comes between the rasa dhatu which is getting generated and the medho dhatu, and all the three doshas are vikruta. Making use of this situation to the best, medhas literally grabs all this rasa dhatu, or rasa dhatu is inclined or biased towards medho dhatu, and practically medha, that alone, or comparatively the medho dhatu is getting the lion's share of the rasa dhatu which is formed. Of course, the rasa dhatu is having all the morbid characteristics which one can imagine, no doubt. Still, it is getting overloaded into the medho dhatu, and practically there is some sort of a disparity between the dhatus as far as getting off the share of rasa dhatu is concerned. In short, this morbid rasa dhatu adding on to the shladha medhas further adds to srodo dushti of the entire system, and as a part, as a result, lot of upadravas are popping up, which is listed out like swasadin, which we have seen already, a list we have already seen. Achirad, in no time, anyan, other diseases like jwarodara bhagandaran, meha, prameha, urustambha, pidaga, vidradhi prabhradin, gadan. At this point, even though it is a adi, etc., etc. usage, I would like to give an extra stress on whatever is named here. This is very important. Swasadin, actually that swasadin is sufficient. The rest of the things may be inferred. But still, some of them are listed. So there will be some speciality, some extra points, which makes these listed diseases listable. These listed diseases listable. So I would say that whenever you find time, whenever you have some good mood, please look into the samprapti of these diseases which are listed. Jwara, udara, bhagandaran, meha, urustambha, pidaga, vidradhi. So please look into the nidana panchaka of these diseases which are listed here and try to understand what is happening to the dhatvagni, srodas, rasa dhatu, jadharagni, and also the status of the dhatus formed, the dushya, that is more important. Dushyas involved in all these diseases, doshas involved in these diseases, and what is happening to the dhatu parinama krama, dhatu agni. And also please remember one point. The sandhi, involvement of the sandhi. Sandhi here means not the joint of the skeletomuscular system, not the joints, like the articulations, nothing like that, but the sandhis existing between dhadus. Sandhis existing between dhadus. This is a very crucial understanding in defining many diseases. Similar way, wherever you find a short list of diseases given as example in a specific context, please look into those diseases. There will be a list. Actually, the general trend what we see is the first name added with Adi is sufficient to represent that group. Jwaradin, Kasadin. But in certain contexts, Acharya is not satisfied with the first member alone. He will be adding more than one diseases. As we see here, Shwasadin, Jwarodara Bhagandharan, Mehorustambha, Pidaga, Vidradi Prabhridin. So Prabhridi is Adi. So to put the Adi in place, he is not confining himself with the first name alone, but giving six or seven vyadhis. So in all such situations, try to understand the way in which the disease is progressing and also see whether these listed diseases are having some interconnectedness in their Nidana Panchaka that may give or that may throw a new light into the understanding of disease progression that can happen, especially in Rogamargas like Shakha. Rogamargas like Shakha. And many a times, the diseases which they have listed may have multiple classifications. Say, for example, here we find Jwara. So, Jwara, we know that there is Andarvegi Jwara, Bahirvegi Jwara, Samajwara, Niramajwara, Agandhujwara, Nijajwara, Leenajwara, Dhadugadajwara. So, nothing is specified, just Jwara is given. But only by understanding the Nidana Panchaka or the samprapti of all these types of jwara, we will be able to understand which jwara is included here. That need not be, even though it is an umbrella term, but all jwaras need not come under in this purview, in this context. Similarly, when we say shwasa, it need not mean all the five types of shwasa. Udara, it need not be all the udaras. Meha, prameha, it need not be all pramehas. Similarly, we find vidradhi, andar vidradhi, bahya vidradhi. So that sort of understanding, sorry that I am talking a little bit out of context of stula, but as this point came, I thought I will just mention it, otherwise I may skip it later. So whenever this list is given, try to understand them contextually. That is very important. So I will come back to Dvidohakramaniyam. Tulyebi vayivadishaye prakshidam chiyadedaram medaha tena asamatvena dhadunam vidadhadi tad shvasadin achiradcha anyan jvarodara bhagandaran meho urustambha pidaga vidradhi prabhridin gadan. And after this, Ashtanga Sangraha Vakbhada gives some sort of a lakshana of stula, how a stula will look like, or how can you mention that this fellow is a stula. So that definition, ayadhopachayulsaha chalaspigudarastanaha adisthulaha smritaha. Ayadhopachayulsaha chalaspigudarastanaha. Ayadhopachayulsaha means ulsaha. We have seen it, the word ulsaha. Ayadhopachay, he has certain upachayam. Upachayam is pushti. Yadhopachayam, as per the level of pushti. Ayadhopachayam, not as per the level of pushti. So even though he is sthula, a brihacharira, he will not show that sort of an enthusiasm which is in accordance with the level of pushti. That is ayadhopachayulsaha. Chala spigudarastana part dehadeshas will be chala because of the medovritti. So this is going to be the characteristic lakshana of sthula. You may be able to make some connection with the body mass index or something like that, but invariably these features shall be looked for. So that is the definition, lakshana wise definition of sthula. Fine. Then next in Ashtanga Hridayam as well as Ashtanga Sangraham, they are going to give you some sort of a management, what is to be done. Tatra medo nilashleshma nashanam sarvam ishyade. Tatra medo nilashleshma nashanam sarvam ishyade. That is the treatment line. That is in Ashtanga Hridayam. Tatra medo nilashleshma nashanam sarvam ishyade. While we come to this point, please recollect what we have seen in the Medo Vriddhi Lakshanas in Doshadi Vijnaniyam chapter. Medo Vriddhi Lakshana. We have Mamsa Vriddhi Lakshana given at that. And after giving Mamsa Vriddhi Lakshana, he will just add on some more features. That Alpe Vijeshtire Swasam Spikstanodara Lambanam. So that Mamsa Vriddhi Lakshanas added on with this Ayadhopajayul Saha, etc., what we have seen specifically here, will go in match with what is listed as Medo Vriddhi Lakshana in Doshadi Vijnaniya. That is interesting. Then certain medicines they are explaining, starting with the Kulattha Jurna Shyamaga Yeva Mudga Madhudagam Mastu Dandahadarishta Chinda Shodhana Jagaram. That is Ashtanga Hridayam. Kulattha Jurna Shyamaga Yeva Mudga Madhudagam Mastu Dandahadarishta Chinda Shodhana Jagaram. Ashtanga Hridayam. But interestingly, we will see what is given in Ashtanga Sangraham as well. Because I think Dosha Bhedi, Dosha Dividhovakramaniyam is complete only with Ashtanga Sangraham. Ashtanga Sangraham mix them together and adds a little bit more light for a better understanding of the context. In Ashtanga Sangraham, Yojyam Tatra Annam Marutapaham Shleshma Medoharam Yacha. Tatra annam marudavaham shleshma medoharam yacha. That is what Hridaya told, medo nila shleshma nashanam sarvamishyade. But that is incomplete. Both these things are incomplete because here the point of interest is highlighted as medha anila shleshma nashanam. Medha anila shleshma nashanam. But that annam is a specific point given in Ashtanga Sangraham. Annam. Tatra annam marutapaham shleshma medoharam. Actually, we know that the Agni is very, very tikshna in sthula. Chut and trit are very excessive. So that point also should be considered. So actually, here, three factors have to be taken care of. Vayu, Agni and Medhas. Medhas accommodates Shleshma as well. So, Medhas, Vayu and Agni are the points to be considered in total. Whereas, here it is limited to the Annam part. But with that Annam, we have to take Aharam and Viharam as well with the Upalakshana concept. Tatra annam marudapaham shleshma medoharam yacha. Then the same list of medicines and the stuffs, cereals, pulses, all those things will be listed here also. Kulaktha yavaga yava jurna shyamaga mudgadhyaha. I am not going to the details of each and every of these stuffs, pulses and everything which are explained. Because I think everybody who are interested in doing these things or putting them into their regular practice may make a menu out of this list and practice. Then paneerishtam madhudagam mastu takram cha. Pane annam, then panam. Pane arishtam madhudagam mastu takram cha. The next line given in Ashtanga Sangraham is very interesting, because there the vihara is precisely explained and the concept in terms of gunas are also accommodated. What we see is tikshnoshnam rooksham chedija bheshajam. So first annam, then panam, now bheshajam. Tikshnoshnam rooksham chedija bheshajam. Rooksham, sorry, tikshnoshnam rooksham chedija bheshajam. Then vihara. Chinda vyavaya vyayama chodhana swapanam bhaje. Chinda vyavaya vyayama chodhana swapanam bhaje. Dehabekshi. Dehabekshi, taking the body as the baseline consideration. Dehabekshi, all these things are to be done. Taking the body, the physical capacity of the individual as the baseline preference. Tatha ruksham snanam udvartananicha. Ruksham snanam means snanam without tailabhyangam. It is known as ruksha snanam. Udvartanam. Udvartana also ruksham. Ruksham udvartanam. All these concepts we find in many other clinical situations explained in the textbooks. Ruksham udvartanam, gadham vyayamo, nisi jagara, yachanyat sleshma medoknam, tat sarvam. That we are seeing. In Prameha we see this thing. Yojananam sadam vyayad, ghanedva salilashayan, goshagrin mutra vrtisyad, gobhireva sahabhramed. So that Goshagran Mutra Vritti, we have to connect with this Tikshnoshnam Rooksham Chedija Bheshajam. Goshagran Mutra Vritti is an example for that. So in Prameha Chikilsa, this concept is used almost in perfect match. Then there are some other combinations. Madhuna Tribhalam Lihyad. Madhuna Tribhalam Lihyad. Gudujim abhayam khanam. Gudujim madhuna lihyad. Abhayam madhuna lihyad. Ghanam musta madhuna lihyad. Then rasanjanasya mahadapanjamulasya guguloho silahvasya prayoganja sagnimandharasohitaha. Sagnimandharasaha. With agnimandharasa you can use rasanjanam. I think it is not that easily available. Mahat panjamulam, guggulu, silajatu. All these prayogas are beneficial in the management of sthaulya. Here again, we have to be more understanding about the precision prescriptions. We have a menu here. Madhuna Tribhalam Lihyad, Madhuna Gudujim Lihyad, Madhuna Abhayam Lihyad, Madhuna Ghanam Lihyad. But we all know that Tribhala, Guduji, Abhaya and Ghana are not the same. They are different. Madhu is common. So a condition which demands the usage of Tribhala need not be the same with the condition which needs Guduji. Similarly, the condition which needs Tribhala, condition which needs Guduji cannot be the same when we use Abhaya or Ghana. So there will be some sort of a difference in the Vikalpa, Vikalpa in the involvement of Dushyas. So where Tribhala is to be used, whether it is when the Medas is more Shlatha, Shithila, something which is very similar to the so-called kleda asadushya, whether ghana is to be used when the grahani part is more morbid, when guduji is to be used where the srodas is going through extensive avarana, whether the abhaya is to be used where all these conditions prevail along with something related with the koshta. All these things are to be looked into and try to come to precise prescriptions. Do not generalize. Even though we have a menu of items, there will be some specificity. Similarly, rasanjanasya sagnimandharasaha mahadapunjamulasya sagnimandharasa prayogaha guguloho sagnimandharasa prayogaha shilakvasya sagnimandharasa prayogaha. They are all beneficial in the management of sthaulyam, but may not be the exact replacements of one another. Need not be the exact replacements of one another. There will be some specificity which we have to draw by different methods. Number one, by understanding the characteristics of these individual things already listed. Number two, by tracing or surveying the literature and understanding the specific context, like vyadhi or samprapti, where these different stuffs are used separately. In the case of Shilajadu, we can understand easily. One particular preparation of Shilajadu called Shivaguliga is given as an excellent rasayana. Shilajadu, after undergoing certain types of bhavana. Shilajadu, when we are doing the bhavana in a different set of swarasas, it becomes a very wonderful aushadha in a specific context called Pandu. And it is a different combination, not Shiva Guliga. It is known as Kaudajavi Gulam or Kaudajatrubhala in the market. So same Shilajadu, even by changing the processing, the bhavana becomes different medicines. So here, Shilajadu with the Agnimandharasa is going to be the ideal preparation for the management of sthaulya. So what is the characteristics of Shilajadu? What is the characteristics of Brihat Panjamula? We all know that Brihat Panjamula is not going to be a substitute for Shilajadu. So that sort of a specificity may be looked into before engaging in the usage of these things. Then next is another yoga. Vilangam nagaram shara kala loharajo madhu yava amalaga churnam ja yoga udisthaulya doshajit. This is a yoga. It's not a menu. Vilangam or vidangam nagaram shara kala loharajo madhu yava amalaga churnam cha yava churnam amalaga churnam. So in short, I think all these things can be made into a churna and given with the madhu. That is adisthaulya doshajit. Please attend or look into the usage, not adisthaulya jit, but adisthaulya doshajit. Adisthaulya doshajit. So it could be a potent combination which is not just reducing the bulk of the body, but also takes care of the different types of comorbidities that can set in, upadravas or vyadhi sankara, all these things that can set in or that can take part in the same show on the stage. So they also to be taken care of and made use of accordingly. Then in Ashtanga Sangraham, a few more combinations are given. They are beautiful. I would like to highlight a couple of them. Madanam Tribhala Musta Saptahwarishta Vansagam Sapadha Aragvatham Pidam Adi Brahmana Rogajit. Again, not Adi Brahmana alone, but Adi Brahmana Rogajit. So आदि ब्रह्मण रोगजित मीन्स आदि ब्रह्मण जन्य रोगजित, आदि ब्रह्मण जन्य रोगजित। वी हैव सीन ए बिग लिस्ट ऑफ डिजीजेस एज वेल एज क्लासिकल फीचर्स ऑफ आदि ब्रह्मण। द डिजीजेस विच वी हैव सीन ऑलरेडी इन अष्टांग हृदय, देन अधिस्थौल्याद आदि क्षुत्र प्रस्वेद श्वास निद्रता आयास अक्षमता जाड्यम अल्पायुर्बल वेगता दौर्गंध्यम गद्गदत्वं च भवेन मेधोदि पुष्टिता। That is what we have seen as condition of sthula. So here this adhisthaulya and adhikshutra prasveda shwasa nidrata are more related with different faculties of daily life which is going to get compromised. So here adhisthaulya rogajit or adhibrahmana rogajit may accommodate all these issues which we have seen now. Madanam, trubhala, musta, saptahva, arishta, valsagam, sapadha, aragvatham, peedam. From the word peedam, we presume that this can be used as a kashaya yoga, or you can make it a churna and make a panam, like dissolving the churna in warm water or takram or whichever is suitable, or arishtam, some madhya visandhana visesham or something like that. This combination is a yoga. Madanam, Trubhala, it is very, very interesting because most of the medicines are freely available. Madanam, Trubhala, Musta, Saptakva, Arishta, Valsagam, Sapadha, Aragvatham, Peedam, Adi Brahmana, Rogajit. And following explaining this line, there is one more statement. Madanadini cha alepaha, snanadishvabi yojayed. Madanadini, whatever we have seen, cha alepaha, you can use them for alepam, sharira alepanam. Then snanadishvabi yojayed, so this can be used as a ruksha udvartana churnam. In sthula, this can be used as a madanadi udvartana churnam, ruksha udvartana churnam. That will be giving you that Brahmana Rogajit effect. Brahmana Rogajit effect. Then, Adi Brahmana Janya diseases, I hope you will recollect. Adisthaulya, Apachi, Meha, Jwara, Udara, Bhagandaran, which we have seen earlier also. Kasa, Sanyasa, Krichrama, Kushtadi, Nadidarunan. So in this Kushta related with Adisthaulya, it is very common, especially that is seen more on the athakkayam, then padam, all these things, areas may be coming under different headings. Sometimes it may be dushtavrana, sometimes it may be kushtavishesha. In all these things, the use of this madanadi churnam may be explored critically. Then another yoga in Ashtanga Sangraham, tadvadu valsaga shamyaga, देवदारु निशाद्वयं समुस्त पाठा खदिर त्रुभला निंबगोक्षुरम। तद्वद, तद्वद मीन्स दिस योगा इज आल्सो आदि ब्रह्मण रोगजित। तद्वद वल्सग शम्याग देवदारु निशाद्वयं समुस्त पाठा खदिर त्रुभला निंबगोक्षुरम। सो दिस आल्सो कैन बी beneficial in managing Adi Brahmana Rogajit. So again, don't think that Valsaga Shamyaga Adi Yoga is a substitute for Madanadi. The indications will be, even though the list is same, but the application point will be, the entry portal could be different. So be explorative in that aspect. So that is about the Sthula Chikilsa in general. And there is another wonderful yoga, which is like a churnam later made into a mandham. Ashtanga Hridayam, Ashtanga Sangraham as well. You can see Vyosha Adi, Vyosha Katvi, Vara, Shigru, Vidanga, Adi Visha, Sthira, Hingu Sauvarchala, Jaji, Yavani, Dhanya, Chitrakaha, बृहत्यौ हपुषा पाढा मूलं च केम्बुगाद् एषां चूर्णं मधुकृतं तैलं च सदृशांशकं सक्तुभि षोडश गुणैर्युक्तं पीतम्। सो दिस इज समथिंग लाइक ए मंधम प्रिपेयर्ड एज ए मंधम। द मेडिसिन्स व्योष कट्वी वरा शिग्रु बिडंग आदिविषा स्थिरा इट इज देयर इन अष्टांग हृदयम एंड अष्टांग संग्रहम। हिंगु सौवर्चल आजाजी यवानी धान्य चित्रकाः निशे बृहत्यौ हपुषा पाढा मूलं च केम्बुगाद् एषां चूर्णं मधु कृतं तैलं च सदृशांशकं सक्तुभि षोडश गुणैः युक्तं पीदं निहन्ति तद्। नौ प्लीज लिसन द फलश्रुति गिवन। क्वाइट इंटरेस्टिंग, क्वाइट इंटरेस्टिंग। अधिस्थौल्यादिकान् सर्वान् रोगान् अन्यांश्च तद्विधान्। सो द लिस्ट अधिस्थौल्य अपजि मेह ज्वरोदर भगंधरान् कास संन्यास कृच्छ्राम कुष्ठादी नदी दारुणान् इस बाय एंड लार्ज कवर्ड फुल्ली बट स्टिल ही इज एडिंग ए फ्यू मोर थिंग्स। अधिस्थौल्यादिकान् सर्वान् रोगान् अन्यांश्च तद्विधान् देन हृद्रोग कामला श्वित्र श्वास कास गलग्रहान्। हृद्रोग कामला श्वित्र श्वास कास गलग्रहान्। देन नेक्स्ट इज सम काम्य प्रॉपर्टीज। अप टू दिस इट वॉज समथिंग लाइक ए नैमित्तिक प्रॉपर्टी, नाउ मोर ऑफ ए काम्य टाइप। वॉट इज दैट? बुद्धिमेधा स्मृतिकरम, बुद्धिमेधा स्मृतिकरम सन्नस्य अग्नेश्च दीपनम, सन्नस्य अग्नेश्च दीपनम अग्निदीपनम। सो हियर इन ए क्लासिकल स्थूल वेर द अग्नि इज ऑलरेडी तीक्ष्ण दिस मे नॉट बी ए गुड चॉइस। So that should be taken care of. But the rest of the Bhalashruti given is quite fascinating. Hridroga Kamala Svitra Shwasa Kasa Galagrahan Buddhi Medha Smritikaram Sannasya Agnescha Deepanam. So please look into this list and find the appropriate clinical situation where this can be effectively used. Sometimes you may be seeing patients complaining of maybe autoimmune thyroiditis, TSH level swinging from this end to that end. Accordingly, the medicine, sometimes it is Thyronorm, sometimes it is Neomercosol. Still, the things are the same. At one point, the person will come back to the square one. It is more like a snake and ladder game. And apart from the TSH value or anti-TPO value, all these things which we will be looking into in papers, the quality of life of the patient may be miserable. He may be or she may be maintaining a good value on papers, but his quality of life, many things will be compromised. So look into this list of options what they have given with the as the benefit of this mantham and try to use them accordingly. And with that, I think we can conclude. Okay. By the way, I would like to remind you that in the next chapter, that means Shodhanadi Gana Sangraham, there are 12 yogas. I just, for a fancy, I just went through the Bhalashruti of those yogas. There are 12 ganas, 12 ganas, which can be seen as having Bhalashruti as good in Medho Dosha. Good in Medho Dosha. So they also may be used with a proper discrimination of precision, where which that aspect shall be taken care of and made use of. Fine. With that, I think we will conclude the Adhisthaulyam, then switch over to Adhikarshya Janya Vikaras. Adhikarshya Janya. that comes as adhikarsyam brahma kasas trishnadhikyam arojakaha snehagni nidra druk srotra shuklauja chut swarakshayaha vasti hrinmurdha jangoru trigaparshwaruja jwaraha pralapaha urdhvanila glani chardi parvasti bhedanam वर्चो मूत्र ग्रहाद्याश्च जायन्तेति विलंघनात्। एर्लियर वी हैव सीन दैट अनपेक्षित मात्रादि सेविदे कुरुदस्तुते अधिस्थौल्य अधिकार्ष्यादीन दैट अधिस्थौल्यादि वी हैव सीन सो फार नाउ दैट अधिकार्ष्यादि विकारास आर लिस्टेड विच आर द रिजल्ट ऑफ अधि विलंघनम अधिलंघनम अधिकार्ष्यम भ्रमः भ्रमः कासः तृष्णाधिक्यम् अरोचकः। नेक्स्ट लाइन एट द एंड वी फाइंड वन क्षयः। विद दैट क्षय ऑल द रेस्ट ऑफ द टर्म्स आर टू बी एडेड स्नेह क्षय अग्नि क्षय निद्रा क्षय दृक् क्षय श्रोत्र क्षय शुक्र क्षय ओजक्षय क्षुत्क्षय स्वरक्षय स्नेहाग्नि निद्रा दृक् श्रोत्र शुक्रौज क्षुत् स्वरक्षयः। देन वस्ति हृन्मूर्ध जंघोरु त्रिकपार्श्वरुजा दैट रुजा इज रिलेटेड विथ ऑल द प्रीफिक्स्ड वर्ड्स वस्तिरुक् हृद्रुक् मूर्धरुक् जंघारुक् ऊरुरुक् तृक रुक् पार्श्वरुक् देन ज्वरः प्रलापः प्रलापः अबद्ध भाषणम् ऊर्ध्वानिल अनिलस्य ऊर्ध्वगामित्वम् समथिंग लाइक ए प्रादिलोम्यम् उदावर्तम् ग्लानि बलहानि छर्दि पर्वभेदनम् अस्थिभेदनम् दैट इज गिवन एज ए स्पेसिफिक थिंग और because lot of these pains are already listed in the line which we saw just before where trigaruja parshvaruja jangharuja urdhvaruja ururuja are already given then specifically parvasthi bhedanam the type of pain is different and areas are different so obviously the samprapti also little bit different then varcho graham mutra graham etc adi jayande adivilanghanad so a long list of issues that can be there with adhikarsyam or adivilanghanam obviously the management is brahmana and one who have already gone through the list of symptoms signs presentations already given one can find that there are duplications like many symptoms are given here as well as adibrahmana janya vyadhis same diseases can be seen listed under adibrahmana janya vyadhis and adilanghana janya vyadhis so that is a tricky point so that is where we have to put our yukti into practice our buddhi into practice because it gives us the clue that any disease can be an outcome of sandarpana or apadarpana so the ultimate manifestation may be say for example jwara for example but when you find a jwara one preliminary assessment that you have to make is whether it is a sandarpana janya jwara or apadarpana janya jwara because the disease may be coming under the heading called jwara but the mechanism behind need not be the same so this actually provokes a lot of thought process what makes a disease that particular disease it is samprapti What is samprapti? Samprapti is the way in which doshas are attacked by dosha. The story of the way in which the doshas are attacked by the dosha. So for one attacking one particular house or attacking one particular establishment, you may have more than one options. Plan A, plan B, plan C can be there. When you chart out a program to attack an establishment, obviously you will be making a plan A, plan B, plan C. Plan A will not be a duplicate of plan B. Plan B will not be a duplicate of plan C. There will be different plans. In the same way, as far as a disease is concerned, how the doshas are going to be attacked by the doshas? There will be a plan A, there will be a plan B, at least two. Plan A will be Sandarpanajanya, plan B could be Abadarpanajanya. So the doshas could be the same, doshas could be the same, but the way that they have traversed could be different. So this point is highlighted in this list of diseases where you find the same disease listed on two different headings, Sandarpanothavyadi and Apadarpanothavyadi. So don't mistake how the same disease can happen by Sandarpana or Apadarpana. So that is why I explained all these things. So we have a big list of signs and symptoms and vyadhis. Also remember what we have seen in Rogabhediyam, that Egascha apacharo nimittam egasya vyadhehe bahunamcha. Egascha apacharo nimittam egasya vyadhehe bahunamcha. The same apachara visesham can cause say one disease or multiple diseases. So that also should be looked at while seeing these presentations. Fine. Here in Ashtanga Sangraham, a few more lines are added which will throw light to the processes what are happening in a krsha, or how adhikarshyam is going to affect the quality of life of a person. It is like adhikarshyena nayasa varsha shidoshna trikshudhaha. Adhikarshyena nayasa varsha shidoshna trikshudhaha tripti vyadhi aushadha madan sahade alpabalatvataha. So a adhikrsha has to compromise on many aspects. Yeah, in Ashtanga Sangraham, what Nilesh is showing, sloga number 49. So see that 48, 49 slogas. Adhikarshyena 49. Nayasa varsha shidoshna trikshudhaha tripti vyadhya aushadha madan sahade. A adhikrsha na sahade cannot tolerate what? Ayasam, physical exertion. Varsha shidoshnam. Varsha shidoshnam means all rudus. Extreme behaviors of all rudus, Varsha, Shida and Ushna accommodates all rudus. Then Trit and Chut, he cannot tolerate Chut or Trit. Tripti, he cannot tolerate Tripti. He cannot tolerate Chut, he cannot tolerate Tripti. Vyadhi, he cannot tolerate Vyadhi. Aushadham, he cannot tolerate all sorts of medicines. Madam, he cannot tolerate Madhyam. So all these things, why? Alpa balatvataha. Adhikarsyena nayasa varsha shidoshna trikshudhaha or chutrishaha tripti vyadhi aushadha madan sahade alpa balatvataha. That is one point, how karsyam is going to compromise the quality of life of a person. Next, as part of adhikarsyam, many comorbidities and complications are going to set in. They are listed. Swasakasa, Kshaya, Pliha, Gulma, Arso, Vannimandata, Krisham Prayascha Dhavandi, Dhavandi. He is chased by many things. Chases him. Krisham Prayascha Dhavandi, Rakta Pitta Jwaramaya. Sorry, I think that padham is a little bit different. It is not Rakta Pitta Jwaramaya. It is Rakta Pitta Anilamayaha. In the text which is shown in the screen, that is, I think it is not right because Jwaram is already included somewhere else. So that is Anilamaya, Rakta Pitta Anilamayaha. Krisham Prayascha Dhavandi, Rakta Pitta Anilamayaha. Having predominance of Pitta and Anila, and having involvement of Rakta. Shwasakasa Kshaya Pliha Gulma Arsho Vannimandaga Krisham Prayascha Dhavandi Rakta Pitta Anilamaya. So Shwasam Kasam we have seen in Brahmana as well. Kshayam will not be there. Pliha, when Pliha is listed, Yagrut also should be understood. Gulma Arsho Vannimandaga, we will be seeing many of these things in Brahmana as well. Rakta Pitta Anilamaya. There it was. Medas was the involved dhadu, and the other things were Vayu and Shleshma and Agni. Here it is a different set of Dushya and Dosha Visheshas. So when we find this Rakta, Pitta and Vayu involvement, on the spot, why, what I presume is Shleshma is Kshina. Shleshma is Kshina. That is why there is Kshaya. And Pitta and Anilas are aggravated. Pitta and Vayu are aggravated. This is a classical situation where the patient needs Brahmana. Where the patient needs Brahmana. Kashaya Pana Pathyanir Deshaha Idi Lenghide Sarpir Dadyad Jarajigilsa Sarpir Dadyad Kabhe Mande Vada Pittotare Jare. Kabhe Mande means Kabhe Chine. Vada Pittotare. So Vada Pitta predominance with Kabhakshaya needs Khridaseva. Vada Pitta Vruddhi with Kabhakshaya needs Khridaseva. In Visarpa Chigilsa, we will find Nirame Sleshmani Kshine Vada Pittotare Hidam Khridam. Nirame Sleshmani Kshine Vada Pittotare Hidam Khridam. There it is, tittam, mahatittam, shrutam, vatrayamanaya. Okay, that continues. But the concept is, kritam is demanded. Here, kshayam of sleshma. That obviously represents kshayam of snigdhada. That obviously again represents the kshaya of ojas. Prakritastu balam sleshma. Then, a few more points what we can connect here is, matrashidiyam. Bhojanam hina matram tu na balobajaya ujase sarvesham vadaroganam hedudam cha pramadyate. That sarvesham vadaroganam list we have already seen. In Charagam Annabhana Vidhi, there is another beautiful line which promotes the proper usage of Anna. Varna prasada sausvaryam jividam pradhibha sukham tushti pushti Balam, Medha, Sarvam, Anne Pradishthidaha. Sarvam, Anne Pradishthidaha. So whatever is listed here stands on the opposite side of whatever we have seen as the presentation of Krisha. Varna, Prasada, Sausvaryam, Jividam, Pradibha, Sukham, Tushti, Pushtir, Balam, Medha, Sarvam, Anne Pradishthidaha. So all these things are to be read together in connection with one another. Now, back in Ashtanga Hridaya, he will be listing out some sort of a strategical understanding. That is, Karshyameva Varam Sthaulyad. Karshyameva Varam Sthaulyad. If you are given with a chance to make a selection, which one will you take? Better go for Karshyam. स्थौल्याद् वरम तद् कार्श्यमेव वरम स्थौल्याद् वाई न हि स्थूलस्य भेषजं ब्रह्मणं लंघनं वालम् स्थूलस्य भेषजं न हि वी हैव ओनली टू टाइप्स ऑफ भेषजं आइदर ब्रह्मणं और लंघनं एंड हियर इन स्थूल व्हाटएवर ट्रीटमेंट यू आर गोइंग टू डू दैट शुड बी अधिमेदो अग्निवादजित सी द चेंज Previously, it was listed as Tatra Medo Lila Sveshma Nashanam Sarvamishyade. Agni was not included. And here it's specifically listed as Adi Medo Agni Vadajit. So, it is quite difficult to find a regimen, either Brahmana or Langhana, which can do these things together, Brahmanam and or Langhanam. So, practically, there is no medicine for sthula, whereas for krsha you have lots of medicine and all the treatments are excellent in terms of their usability and patient compliance because all are asking you to be more comfortable, more relaxing, more luxurious, more peaceful. So the line of management is easy and comfortable. Whereas the line of management is sthula is quite paradoxical many a times and quite difficult to comply with. So, karshyameva varam sthaulyad nahi sthulasya bheshajam brahmanam lenghanam valam adimedogni vadajit. And I think we have a few more slogans to complete. I hope tomorrow, next lesson session we will complete it and we will start the next portion. Today, I think we spend a lot of time in evaluating that the clinical application of certain yogas. I hope you all enjoyed and make use of it in your clinical practice. You will be more explorative and more curious to find the application part of those yogas. I hope we will conclude today at this point because it's already 28:28. Vaidya Nilesh, please take over.
Yes, thank you, sir. Today was a special treat with all these yogas and the practical application of that. As you said, everybody might have enjoyed it. I personally felt that these are very practical and we should use it in our daily practice, sir.
Very good, very good. Because I think that sort of experiences will make everybody more confident. I have also tried many of these Lebana yogas and Snana yogas. And I have tried that Vyoshadi Mandha Churnam in certain conditions, taking special interest on that Buddhi Medha Smriti Karam. So I think everybody can try it and report in our coming sessions.
Yes, very good. We will be very eager to hear what we can say, experience of patients, which you experienced in your patients, basically.
It is quite impressive. It is quite really working. I hope from my sound, you will be feeling the confidence with which I am expressing these things. Unfortunately, yes. As we are not using, you may not be able to see my body language. But the yes. voice which I am using this is quite confident. I have seen many of these things in my clinical practice.
Yes, yes, definitely, sir. So, we will see a few questions, sir.
Please.
Yes. The first question is, how to prepare Madhu Kodak? Is there any separate formula?
I don't think so. It is a panam. So madhu mixed with the udagam, jalam is enough. I don't think that there could be. I think because there are many recipe books like Bhojana Kutuhalam or that sort of things are there. So there may be some recipe. It is more about the recipes. So there may be as you know, even in boiling the water, there are many vidhis. Like reducing to half, reducing to 1/4, reducing to 1/16, like that, and the qualities of different types of that Kodhida Jalam is also listed. So sometimes there may be vidhi for Madhudagam in some of the recipe books of earlier days. These couple of books I have seen is this Bhojana Kuduhalam, and that one more is there with the same name, the Kuduhalam. I forgot the name. So maybe the Koshna or normal Madhudaga. I think it should not be Koshna. It should be normal, because I think Madhu used with the Ushnam Ushnartam Ushneja Yuktam Joshnair Nihanditad. So it should not be used with anything Ushna. Use it normal.
Yes, sir. Practically also, in while we take case history, we come across people taking Ushnodak and Madhu.
Yes, yes.
For reducing weight. So it's a
I have seen, I think. Yeah, I have seen one. Yeah, some, that Kshema Kutuhala. Gopika is added the Kshema Kutuhala. I forgot that name. Fine. So I have seen, personally, I have witnessed one case. Unfortunately, it was a young allopathic doctor, a lady who got a little bit of bulky, maybe because of lack of exercise and other thing. Interesting thing is that without any discrimination, any evidence, she used this Ushna Madhudagam, and she is no more because of her portal veins, portal system, the liver system got completely damaged, and she died maybe at the age of 35 or something like that. So I would request everybody not to venture into that sort of things. Yeah, then somebody has Vaidya Vinod. Sharangadhara Samhita Adamalla Tika has reference of Madhu Udaga, two pal Udaga and half pal Madhu. Very good. I hope everybody is seeing that reference which is given by Vaidya Vinod. I will post in the group the exact reference. Very good, very good. Adamalla commentary of Sharangadhara Samhita. Two pal Udaga and half pal Madhu. Very good.
Yes, okay. Sir, we'll move to next question.
Yes.
Yes. What is the Shodhan that which is explained in Vihar Chikitsa of Sthula?
What is the Shodhan which is explained in the Vihar Chikitsa of Sthula? I did not get that question correctly, to be very honest. What they have explained is, in Ashtanga Sangraham gives a very clear idea about it, but it is not Vihara Chikilsa, it is Chikilsa only. That at one point Ashtanga Sangraham, he explains Yojyam Tadha Yadha Vyadhi Sveda Asrit Sravananyabi. Yojyam tadha yadha vyadhi, that is the guideline. Yadha vyadhi. Yadha vyadhi means according to the comorbidities, presentations, and the dosha vikalpa or upadravas present, you have to make use of sveda asrit sravanani api. So sveda is indicated, asrit sravana is indicated. If you prefer to, you can go for whichever shodhana you feel like, provided that every conditions are properly met with. One direct point that the Acharya has specified is yojyam tadha yadha vyadhi. So yadha vyadhi is the point in it. Sthula is actually very durbala. So generally, very classical shodhana needs vyadhi bala. It is lacking here. So that point should be kept in mind before trying for a very extensive shodhana chikitsa. But doing controlled svedana, udvartana type of kabhahara chikitsa, all these things could be beneficial. But before going for a classical shodhana, you should have a thorough assessment.
Yes. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Fine.
Next question is about Vyaushadhi Sattu. I think it will be covered in the next session, or?
Vyaushadhi is what we have already explained. That Vyaushakatvi Varashigru, if I am right. What was the point? What was the question?
proportion of taila ghruta madhu with churna. What
it
is
is
the
there in the it is already explained as such, no? There is nothing specific about that. Means all these powders are to be taken in equal quantity, then with the same quantity you have to add honey, ghee and tailam separately. So one part powder, one part honey, one part ghee, one part tailam. Then 16 times of this powder, that means 1:1:1:16. The saktu should be 16 times. Then take it in sufficient quantity of water and do the make it as a mandham and consume. One part churna, one part madhu, one part krita, one part taila, 16 part that saktu. But there are some difference in commentaries, like 1:1:1:1:64. That sort of a commentary you may find, but this is the way in which it is used here. Okay.
So, okay, sir. Thank you. The next question is, sir, you have asked to go through sandhis existing between dhatus here. Can you please brief about dhatu sneha parampara?
Yeah, that is a tough question. That is a really a very, very important question. See, I do not know how I came to that point in this context, because it is a very, very finer understanding of the dhatu parinamam. Dhatu parampara is a sneha parampara. From rasa to ojas, it is a parampara. And there are a lot of mechanism playing behind this transformation. I do not know how much time I will get. Anyway, I think we will discuss it in detail in another session, but I will give you some brief. So, please listen. One dhadu to another dhadu, there is a transformation and refining of snehana, but that is not just refining of the snigdha property. Certain gunas are added, certain gunas are withdrawn. Then only it can be transformed into the next dhadu. So between these two dhadus, there is a junction where these mechanism can be seen operating. It cannot be seen, it can be inferred. And that activity which is going on in such a junction is very crucial as far as the way in which the sneha is transformed, the amount of sneha is transformed, and the outcome is defined. All these things are dependent upon this sandhi. And please read this sandhi along with the concept of kala. Read this sandhi along with the concept of kala. So kala is becoming a very important concept in Ayurveda. Kala. We have never taken due respect to the concept called kala. We have just read it as if something a passing show while going through the Sharira question paper. But kala is the crux of this dhadu parampara, sneha parampara. And that is where this sort of addition of gunas and withdrawal of gunas are happening, making sure that this next stage of the material is generated. So while dealing with different sorts of diseases, especially in the shakha which involves the dhadu parampara, you should be able to identify which dravya has got precise affinity towards each of these sandhis, which dravya is having a precise interest in this sort of sandhi. So you will be dealing with the concept of kala. So that will make your management plan entirely different, and you will be dealing, you will be seeing the case in a different light. So that is very important. I do not know how much I conveyed it, but I think when we go through the chikilsa later, maybe after dealing with a few chapters of maybe Charirasthanam and Vidhanasthanam, when we go through the chapters like especially the concepts of why the Pandu Shobha and Visarpa is coming to a single chapter in Ashtanga Hridayam, why this Trishobhiyam concept is becoming very important, you will be getting a clear-cut idea. So I think we will wait for it, because at this point it is not easy to explain everything. But I think that is going to be a million-dollar question when we discuss Nidanam and Chikilsa. So please keep it on reserve for our Nidanam Chikilsa sessions, if everything is favorable, because I do not know when we will reach in Nidanam and Chikilsa. Okay.
Yeah. Yes. Thank you, sir. Then we have few mentions about this Shruta Sheeta to be used is mentioned in Sharangdar Samhita. For
very good, very good.
I think we can advise Shruta Sheeta Jala for Madhudak.
Yes.
And again, Vaidya Kumar has commented, with the same elements, what decides whether it is going to be Santarpana or Apatarpanottha, whether it is the Vihara that decides it?
Yeah, it could be Vihara. How to understand whether it is Santarpanottha or Apatarpanottha, or which decides the Santarpanottha or Apatarpanottha. I think the status of Agni is going to be very important. So when you are having a Manda Agni and you are consuming lot of Guru Ahara, obviously you are prone to Santarpanottha Vyadis much easily than many other normal people. So Vihara is also, when you are habituated with the daytime sleep, when you are habituated with the frozen food, all these things are going to make you more vulnerable for Santarpanottha Vyadis. At the same time, when you have got a habit of skipping meals very frequently, so you will be, obviously, even though the rest of the meals what you are taking could be very nutritious, very proper, very heavy, if you are used to have the habit of skipping meals, the point what you have to understand is rukshada is slowly creeping in into your system. So rukshada creeping into the system on a daily basis is making you prone for Apatarpanottha Vyadis, even though you may not look like that, because on the other side you may be eating over and you may be gaining a lot of medas, but still the circulating rukshada will be making you prone to Apatarpanottha Vyadis. So I think Vihara, Ahara, all these things are decisive in this picture.
Yes. Okay, sir. And the last question is, sir, there is a reference that Ghruta and Madhu should not be in equal quantity. Please guide about it.
Yeah, that is true. But it is a case about use of Madhu and Ghruta alone. If there is a third ingredient, I think it is not Madhu and Ghruta. So when Madhu and Ghruta used together in equal quantities, I think it is not ideal. As we saw in the case of Madhu with Ushnodaga, it can be, I think, hazardous in the long run. May not be something like an on-the-spot fatality, cannot be expected. But I think it could be deranging many of the koshtangas.
Yes, thank you, sir. And I think Vaidya Vinod has commented about the sutra. I would request him to just post in our WhatsApp group so that everybody will be benefited with this.
Yeah, I think